Imagine you're at the airport, queuing at the boarding gate, ready to board your flight. You're praying you won't be late because you have a connection. Everything seems fine, but suddenly, ladies and gentlemen, we kindly ask you to immediately reach the exit. There has been a security violation. Nothing to worry about, but we need to rescreen all passengers. At this stage, you may want to scream, but if you have a PhD, you want to find a justification for what's happening. Protecting an airport is a pretty complex activity. You have to prevent malicious individuals from attacking your airport, prohibited items from entering the sterile area, staff members from putting in place dangerous behaviors. These things are called landside operations, and they mainly involve security. At the same time, you have to make sure that your aircrafts land and take off safely, that nobody gets hurt while loading or unloading baggage, that nobody uses their mobile phones on the tarmac. These things are called airside operations, and they mainly involve safety. Now, my point is, if you spend a couple of days wandering around an airport, you will notice that airport organizations are airports' worst enemies, not terrorists. Why? Complacent flight assistants that leave security doors open behind them, reckless truck drivers that speed around the aircrafts, lazy safety officers that don't perform their inspection of the airfield and don't pick up that bunch of ibises grazing in the grass. And a bird strike can bring down a plane. So my question is, how can we improve the safety and security of our airports by reducing the risks of dangerous practices, attitudes, and behaviors put in place by airport organizations? In order to answer this question, I spent 20 days in three Australian airports. I interviewed 30 managers and officers, and I examined 3 kilos of safety and security documents. My thesis is a qualitative study that adopts a single case study approach and assesses the organizational vulnerability of airports. Results emphasize that business models, organizational cultures, training practices have a deep impact on safety and security. Let's take a familiar example, low-cost carriers. They are like greedy partners. They want you to take them out for dinner in a fancy Italian restaurant to pay for everything and to be quick because they have to meet somebody else afterwards. In airports, low-cost carriers are the same. They go for the cheapest ground handlers. They save on safety and security training. They put time pressure on their contractors. They cut staff members down to the bone. The result? Reduced safety and security. Now, think back to earlier when you were queuing at the boarding gate. The security violation was not a terrorist as you were thinking. It was just a tired security officer that didn't pick up a fork in a passenger's bag. So, are you really sure of what happens in our airports beyond that safe and secure surface that you see when you travel? Thank you.